between the team from Sault Ste. Marie, the St. Mary's College Knights, taking on maybe the Cinderella story of the tournament, the Villanova Wildcats, right here from LaSalle. My name is Dominic Papa, joined by our very capable color commentator, Mr. Steve Pronger. Good morning to you, Steve.
Dom, good morning. What an exciting day it is, especially if you're a Villanova Wildcat fan. What a Cinderella story for sure. I remember last week on your radio show, Coach Grant O'Keefe said they're just happy to be here. There was no expectations, Dominic, and look where they are today.
Well, they're going to play for a medal. We don't know which medal yet, but they are going to get a chance to win a medal. This St. Mary's team is, from Sault Ste. Marie, though, I've heard nothing but rave reviews. This is going to be a very formidable task for Villanova. St. Mary's comes into this game in their league play, Steve. Their season record 38-1, league record 15-1. So this is a high-caliber team.
For sure. And they come into this game 4-0, Dom, out of pool play. They haven't lost yet. There's Coach Oliveria and his capable staff, the Knights team. They're ready to go 4-0. But, Dom, you know what? One of the things that led Villanova to here was the play of goaltender Lucas DeLuca.
Yeah, he's been phenomenal. A couple of shutouts in this tournament in their four wins. And he's been everything and more, actually, for this team. And they've had key contributions at very timely segments in the game, which is always huge in a tournament like this. I think right away, Steve, even, you know, it's an 8 o'clock game in the morning here. I think now when you get to this point of the tournament, you look at the physical play. You look at who's going to be able to do it physically. These are tired teams. They've had a very intense week of hockey, 4 games in 2 days. And now you come and play an 8 a.m. in the morning game. This is going to be a tough task for both teams. I don't care how good you are. It comes down to that physical desire to find the extra reserves in the tank. And you know what? As a lot of coaches always say, both these teams just have to leave it on the ice, see what happens at the end.
Yeah, tomorrow doesn't matter anymore. One thing you may want to consider, as we know, Dominic, Villanova's been able to stay at home and sleep in their own beds, the comfort of mom's cooking, we could say. St. Mary's has been living out of a bus in a hotel room in a suitcase. We'll see if that's going to be a factor today.
It can be. I mean, you've done your share of traveling. I've done my share of traveling, and it's always nice to be at home and have that home-cooked meal. And you know what? The other thing is they're getting a good crowd assembled here, a lot of Villanova people coming into the game. So maybe that crowd could be somewhat of a factor in this as it goes on. But you know what? Bottom line is you've got four really good teams left here. Of course, we got our second game, our second set of games will be at 1 o'clock today. That'll be the bronze medal game. Yourself along with Bill Kelso will call that. And then the gold medal game at 3 o'clock. We don't know who's going to be there yet, but it's going to be fun. So glad to have you on board here on we-tv.ca. And we are underway here at the Vollmer Center. And right away, St. Mary's, a quick shot. That comes off the stick of Matthew Keenan, number 8. And right away, Lucas DeLuca snaps out the leather and makes it look easy.
Yeah, both teams are happy there. St. Mary's wants to feel the puck, get shots on DeLuca early, and also DeLuca wants to feel that puck and get into the game.
And there's another save for DeLuca off the faceoff.
Coach O'Keefe explained to me, Don, that his team has to be defensively sound today. They know what St. Mary's has for them. It's going to be a tremendous hockey game.
It's a good test, that's for sure. The Wildcats break out of their zone, lead the rush. It's a two-on-two situation. Long shot, just bounces into the corner. Stuck on the net behind there, and we'll get the play blown down, and face-off, I believe, will come inside the St. Mary's College zone.
Yeah, if you look at goaltender Cilelli there.
Michael Cilelli?
Yeah, he's very goaltender. This goaltender is one that he's going to ride the remainder of the tournament. He'll play again this afternoon. He's happy to feel that puck, wants to get into the game.
Look at the St. Mary's College bench, and the big man there right in the middle, that's Mike Oliveira, the head coach. He's done a great job with this team. When you get this far, Steve, in any hockey, I don't care what level it is, you've done good things.
Yeah, Dom, we heard at the banquet the other night there were 780 high schools participating in high school hockey in the province, and now we're down to 4.
Yeah, well, there you go. Big hit there at center ice just moments ago. This is Cicchini. A number of Italians in that Sault Ste. Marie roster, so I'm going to have a pretty easy day with this, actually. So
I might struggle, Dom.
I'm almost feeling like at home here. Cicchetta leaves the puck behind the net. There's a tussle back there. Cicchetta falls up, loose puck out front, right off the stick. That comes off the stick of Adam Baggs, number 6. His shot goes wide of the net. Here's Rowe, the captain. Austin Rowe circles, sends it back to the point. This is Cecchini, his long shot, saved by DeLuca and steered right into the corner. Cecchetta cycles back, tries to send it out front, nobody home there. Here's a quick one-timer shot. DeLuca right there on top of the blue ice and makes a good save. DeLuca looking very much like himself, Steve. Yeah. A lot of confidence and really challenging the shooters.
One thing I've noticed about DeLuca over the last couple days, Dom, he has no trouble playing on top of the blue ice. He's confident out there. His shoulders are square. Coach O'Keefe and his group there looking, you know, they're confident as well. They're happy to be here, but they've become believers, Dominic.
Well, they should be. I mean, you know, they were given the 16th seeding in this tournament, which was the final seeding, but you know, no offense to the other teams, but this Villanova team's a quality team, and I think they're much higher than a 16th seed. I don't know where you would put them, but certainly not at 16.
Well, right now I put them at least number four.
Well, that's a fair argument. You've got a good argument there. You should be work the law for them and fight that case. Here comes St. Mary's again as they've been controlling the early play here, carrying the play to Villanova. That puck shot down the length of the ice. That's going to be an icing call. But right now, St. Mary's seems to have a little bit of the step going here over Villanova.
Yeah, they're going to want to keep the puck in the other end of the rink, of course. St. Mary's is going to try to want to play down low, Dominic, below the hash marks in the Villanova end, and that's going to tire out the Villanova defenders. When that happens, they want to bring the puck up to the point for shots on net.
Lucas Miller-Ferreira in the faceoff circle for St. Mary's. I believe that was Ernest Godden, the captain of Villanova, taking the draw. Of course, he is the son of former OHL great Ernie Godden, who still holds the league record for most goals in a season, Steve.
Dominic, did you ever expect you'd be calling the name Ernie Godden in a high school game?
No, you know what? Just tells me it's time for me to move on, Steve. That's what it tells me. But good stuff to see his son playing. And Ernie, of course, one of the great guys in our area, that's for sure. Here comes St. Mary's, that's Menard, his pass goes astray. Villanova will have a chance to clear, and they do just that. Here's Godden, he sends it over to the left side, and they lose the puck inside the blue line. Rowe sends it up ice, his pass intercepted. Villanova not mustering much offense right now as St. Mary's, again, has come out with some pretty good intensity. Play behind the Knights' net. Comes out front. Here's a chance for Villanova. Saved by the goaltender. That was Cilelli with his first big test. Another shot, and that's off a stick up over the netting, but Cilelli faces his first test, and he's equal to the test.
Dom, we've been wondering when Villanova might get the puck up ice and pressure Cilelli, and here it comes right now. Villanova working hard behind the net. They're going to bring that puck out front in the first big test on Cilelli.
Right off of Ernest Godden's stick.
Charlie comes up big early in this hockey game.
From the faceoff, St. Mary's controls. That's Bags. His right side pass connects. Here's number eight. That's Keenan. Keenan sends it into the corner. Cicelli goes and gives chase number 17. His pass doesn't connect. Trunzo to the point. Long shot. That's deflected right into DeLuca. That's shot coming off of Carmen Scarfone's stick, number 20.
Dominic, that's what I said. The St. Mary's Knights, they're going to want to bring that puck up high to the point. He told me straight out that was the strategy they're going to use and get shots in at DeLuca, try to get traffic on the front of the net so that smallish goaltender can't see anything.
Keenan against Godden in the faceoff circle. Keenan controls it now. He'll send it down low, start the cycle. Riding his man out is John Purdy, number five for the Wildcats. Purdy, a very solid, sturdy defenseman. Up the boards, kept in at the point. Villanova now gets another rock at it. Here's Purdy. He'll lead it out. He'll skate it out. He sends it up ice to his line mate. That's number 26, and I don't have him on our roster, Steve. I apologize. We'll have to get that corrected. Cole Welsh sends it in for Villanova. Play behind the net. Here's Bags. Bags has already seen a lot of ice time in this first 5 minutes. Welsh, quick pass up to his teammate Mitch Schmidt. Schmidt stopped at the half wall. Schmidt lets it go to the point. There to intercept it is Cecchetta. Cecchetta, right side pass to Stefano. Stefano to Cecchetta. He can't control that pass. He'll wrap it around the wall, send it behind the net. Comes all the way over to the other side. Keeping it in is Dyer. He sends it down low again, back to the point to Dyer. Dyer has time and space. Dyer almost lets it come out of the blue line, keeps it in. Oh, here's Rowe, his long shot, wide of the net. St. Mary's pressing hard here, and finally Villanova is able to put it into the neutral zone. sending it right back in are the Knights. Play on the right side. Here's a shot from Stefano. Good save there by DeLuca. Kept in at the point momentarily. No, it did get out. A break there for the Wildcats, but DeLuca again tested, comes up with a nice save.
Dominic, as we look at the St. Mary's defender heading back to the bench, St. Mary's is going to pepper DeLuca with shots from the point all day long, I believe. But it appears that Villanova is going to let them do that. They're choosing to protect the goaltender in the house with their people as opposed to getting out on the point man.
Fizikas gives chase that puck. He's knocked down. Play comes around to the right side. Kept in at the point by the Wildcats, number 17, Bryce McGregor. Fizikas behind the net takes a hit, continues on, sends it back to McGregor. McGregor looks. McGregor sends it off the half wall, gets it right back. He'll twist now, McGregor does, and he keeps it in for the moment. But unfortunately for Villanova, they can't hem in the Knights. Play in the neutral zone now. This is Trunzo over to number 9. That's Jacob Porco. That play broken up, keeping it in number 20. Carmen Scarfone moving up on the play. Menard for the Wildcats. Left side pass to Pignanelli. Pignanelli, his right side pass over to Fizikas. Fizikas with some room. Fizikas tries to feather pass. Menard had a chance to get a shot, or Pignanelli had a wide open chance and couldn't get the shot off. Here comes St. Mary's, number 9. That's Jacob Porco over the blue line. Porco looks, tries to make a move, takes a good solid hit from Godden right into the slot area as Godden timed it perfectly. Villanova now slowly moving out of the zone. That pass intercepted. Here's a chance for the Knights, and fortunately for Villanova, they couldn't connect on that pass.
Villanova's got to watch those people. They can't leave the zone and leave people behind.
Play behind the Wildcats net. Now along the boards right out into the slot area. Quick shot, that just goes wide off the stick of Sachetta. St. Mary's pressing hard, really laying the body right now. Here comes Godden. Godden leads the rush. Right side pass over here to Geniak. Geniak can't control it. Bags takes over for St. Mary's. Oh my, what a huge hit by Bags as he just laid out Pignanelli, I believe that is, number 15. He is slow getting up. He is shaken up. Wow, what a hit.
Dominic, I was just thinking as we look at the Villanova player down on the ice, I don't know if we can be sure who it is at this point.
I believe it's Pignanelli, number 15, Daniel Pignanelli.
Dominic, I was just thinking, when you get to halfway through a period of hockey and no one appears to have control of the puck or control of the game, shots on net, things will start to get physical. One team or another has to dominate the ice physically to try to open up more room for themselves. It looks like that's starting to happen.
Well, hopefully, you know, it looked like a pretty clean hit, Steve. Hopefully, he's just winded. You know, we'll see, but make no mistake about it. Number 6, Adam Bags, lined him up perfectly. And
yeah, St. Mary's, you know, I was just starting to feel they're going to start to get physical. They're a long way from home. This means everything for them today. They want to stay here and play for gold.
That's Francia. Francia over the blue line. Quick shot. No, he fakes it. He takes a hit from Brunetta. Brunetta takes over the puck now. Nicholas Brunetta leads Russ. He's stripped of the puck by Jameson. Pass out front. Doesn't connect. Scrum going on in the corner to the stick side of the goaltender. Shot scores! A deflection! And it rolled right over the goaltender, number 30, Michael Cilelli. Maybe a break there for the Wildcats, Steve.
Dom, we look at that celebration in front of Coach O'Keefe's bench there. Why not? The Villanova Wildcats find themselves up one. I was just wondering how they would respond, if they would respond to the physicalness with more physicality. But no, Dom, they're pressuring up ice. They put up a shot. Chiarelli can't get it. It's deflected over him. Tremendous goal for the Villanova Wildcats. They go up 1-0.
Chris Francia will get the goal. The goal coming at 9:41 of the period. And just like that, you know, when St. Mary's has been carrying the bulk of the play, Steve, Villanova creates a break for themselves. Let's see if it changed some of the momentum here. Cecchini trying to respond to a shot saved by DeLuca right on the doorstep as Austin Rowe, the captain, had a juicy rebound. Here come the Wildcats now as they break out of their zone. This is Fizikas. Fizikas shot saved there by Cilelli, and he holds on for the faceoff. But the intensity picking up.
Dominic, that goal, of course, was scored by number 8 for Villanova Wildcats, Chris Francia, from, of course, Jacob DeLuca, giving the Wildcats a 1-0 lead. You know,
4:48 remaining here in the first period of this OFSAA semifinal game between Villanova and St. Mary's from Sault Ste. Marie. Villanova, of course, the hometown favorite here in LaSalle. Shot from the point, handled easily there by Cilelli. That shot coming from Bryce McGregor.
You know, Prancia there, number 8 for Villanova, our goal scorer, Dom. He was a recipient of going to the right place at the right time, getting a stick on that shot. Goaltender Cilelli goes down, popped over him, couldn't handle it.
It was almost like a long basketball shot, but the way it looped, Steve.
But this is why, Dominic, put everything at the net in playoff or tournament hockey.
Godden's shot blocked in front there. Here's Rowe, the captain. He can't connect with his linemate, Trunzo. Puck kept in there by Scarfone. Villanova now trying to create some room now. Hutchins up to Godden. He can't handle it. He avoids a check. Boy, these guys, I'll tell you what, Steve, they're going at each other pretty good. Godden's got a pretty good battle going with Lucas Michael Ferrer, number 19. We'll keep an eye on that. Brunetta, quick pass over to Trunzo. He takes a hit immediately. Keenan can't get anywhere. Puck goes behind the net. Now Keenan with a little bit of room trying to come out front, and Villanova breaks that up. Here comes the Wildcats. Quick dump in behind the net. Giving chase is Rosa here, number 21. He takes a hit from Dyer, number 22. Keenan knocked down, and it's getting physical, Steve. The physicality is definitely picking up here.
Yeah, St. Mary's, Dom, is going to stick to that theme. They started getting physical halfway through this period. They can't let up on that right now.
Dyer's pass going on the length of the ice, icing nullified. Purdy can't handle it. Loose puck here. Here comes a chance for St. Mary's. That shot goes wide as Sacchetta had a chance. Cecchini from the point. His shot steered into the corner by DeLuca. Pretty. His pass right to the point. Not a good clear. Blocked, though, fortunately for the Wildcats, as that shot comes off the stick of Scarfone. Villanova has to be careful, Steve, with that first pass.
Dominic, many times yesterday they turned over the puck, and really not on this day. Today is not the day for turnovers.
Pretty. His pass goes off a leg, stays in for a moment, but Villanova finally able to clear the puck down the length of the ice.
Dominic, sometimes a young defenseman is better to eat the puck in his own zone than just try to get it out with a prayer.
DeLuca, Jacob DeLuca, who got an assist on that first goal. His pass off the glass. Bags goes back for St. Mary's. Left wing pass up here to number 11, Sacchetta. He can't get anywhere with it. Puck cleared out of the zone. Giving chase is Schmidt. Schmidt now comes up with it for Villanova. Over to his line mate, that's number 8, Francia, who has the goal. Francia in the corner. out front. Quick shot, blocked, and goes back into the corner. That shot coming off the stick of number 16, Tyler Jameson. Another pass out front, and Villanova can't control it. Schmidt just taps it into the corner. Jameson back to Schmidt. Behind the net, off to the side of the net. Here's Rowe, the captain for St. Mary's now, clearing it out. Left side rush, and Rowe taken down nicely there by Jameson, and that puck slowly goes into the goaltender, Lucas DeLuca. He'll cover up. 1:37 remaining here in the first period.
DeLuca's done what he has to do right there. As we look at the Oliveria, the coaching staff of the St. Mary's Knights, they're wondering, what do they have to do? They've thrown everything at the Villanova net. Coach Grant O'Keefe and his squad, they should be very happy with the play of DeLuca up to this point.
Nice crowd assembled here at the Vollmer Center. A lot of the locals have come out to support this Wildcat team, that's for sure. Quick shot by Rowe, that's blocked out front. Villanova has done a great job, Steve, as one of the players is shaking up, that's McGregor, but the Wildcats have done a great job of getting bodies in front of the shots, Steve.
And that's what Coach O'Keefe told me he has to do. He has to crowd his net, protect his goaltender.
This is Stefano leading the rush for St. Mary's. He can't find a teammate to dish off to. Villanova takes over the puck. Off the glass into the neutral zone. Keenan just dumps it right back in for St. Mary's. That pass doesn't connect. Villanova will try one more time. This is Geniak. His pass over to linemate Rosa doesn't connect very well. Here comes Porco for the St. Mary's team. He knocks his man down pretty, but Villanova takes over the puck. Half a minute to go here in the first period. 1-0, the Wildcats. And again, St. Mary's just the dump and chase consistently. Kept in here at the point by number 19, that's Ferreira. Into the corner, Welsh sends it to the right side. Good scrum going on there in the half wall as St. Mary's is able to keep it in into the corner. Time winding down in this first period, just 5 seconds to go as St. Mary's trying to get one last crack at that Villanova net. There goes the buzzer. That ends the first period of play. 15 minutes is in the book in this OFSAA semifinal game. Our score after 15 minutes play, it's the Villanova Wildcats 1, the St. Mary's Knights. No score. We're going to take a timeout. We'll come back. We'll continue our coverage of OFSAA AAA Boys Hockey Championships here on we-tv.ca.
To the final basket, the St. Clair College Sportsplex will host the best Canada has to offer in women's collegiate basketball. March 16th through March 19th, 8 teams will be putting their best on the floor to gain basketball supremacy at the CCAA level. Complete coverage of this action-packed event hosted by St. Clair College Saints Athletics can be watched exclusively on www.we-tv.ca. We TV, bringing Windsor and Essex County to the world. On Monday, March 28th, the best of Windsor and Essex County sports and athletics will be on display at the 11th Annual Westby Awards, the Sports Oscars of Windsor and Essex County. Joining the celebration and bringing her message of triumph and inspiration will be keynote speaker Miss Heather Abbott, a Boston Marathon bombing survivor. Tickets for the Westby Awards are available at Bob Reum Sports, 4275 Tecumseh Road East, and Windsor Essex Television, located at 6270 Hawthorne Road. Discounted group rates are available. For more information, please visit www.thewesbys.ca. The 11th Annual Westby Awards are brought to you by Unifor Local 444, Central Park Athletics, AM 800 CKLW Radio, and WE TV.
Welcome back to the Vollmer Center, the site of the 2016 OFSAA Boys AAA Hockey Championships here on WE TV. Dominic Papa along with Steve Pronger, the hard-working crew here at WE TV. It's an early morning, but it's an exciting morning, that's for sure, Steve.
Dominic, there's nothing better than early morning hockey. Anyone who is a hockey fan in Canada knows that mornings are associated with hockey. What a tremendous game we have so far. The host team, Villanova Wildcats, up 1-0 on a goal from Chris Prancia, assisted by Jacob DeLuca. Wow, and you combine that with terrific goaltending from Lucas DeLuca. Awesome.
See some of the crowd here. We've got a good crowd. A lot of the locals have come out to help the Villanova cause here. You see some Villanova jerseys And that's where the home ice advantage thing comes into play, Steve, hosting this tournament. And actually, it's been pretty well attended, and there's been some great hockey throughout the week here, that's for sure.
As we look at our screen there, you can see at home you're getting your typical three-minute break between periods. The referee's getting a drink, washing their face with the towel, of course. But I think the story, if you look for Oliveira, really is his group decided they're going to come out and play physical hockey. We see it specifically halfway through the first period. But, you know, on the other hand, we wondered how Villanova would respond as we look at their bench. And Dominic, you know what? They didn't respond physically. They put one in the net.
Well, again, I think it was the tale of two periods that first period, Steve. St. Mary's came out and set the tone for sure. They were the they were the aggressor in that first period. I thought, for the most part, really had more chances, significant chances, than that of Villanova. But Villanova's been a very opportunistic team in this tournament. And again, they've come in here with the attitude, nobody's expecting anything from us. We'll just take what we can get, and we'll go from there.
Dominic, that's called lull you to sleep hockey. I'm not saying it's bad hockey, but you know, sometimes you play a controlled game, you don't take chances, and all of a sudden, wow, you pop out, you put one in.
Again, this is our first of three games today here on WE TV. Got to give credit to this WE TV crew. What a great bunch of people putting this together. But our next game will take place at 1 o'clock. That will be the bronze medal game, Steve, and you'll be here for that. I'll be here for that. Also, Bill Kelso will bring you the play-by-play for that game. And then our game after that's 3 o'clock game, so that'll be the third game, our final game. This will be the final game of the tournament. It'll be a 3 o'clock start. That's the gold silver medal game, and we'll have all the action for you in that contest as well. Bill Kelso and Steve Pronger bringing you all the action in that one.
Dominic, the question I have, will one of these two teams be in that gold medal game at 3 o'clock this afternoon? I'm sure the Villanova Wildcats fans hope they can pack this arena at 3 o'clock. School will be out, of course.
Well, I'm sure they'll make an exception if they're...
Absolutely. You know. But on the other hand, we hope that the friends and families and the schoolmates of the St. Mary's Knights, they may tune in at 3 o'clock here on WE TV as well.
So we're just about set for the second period of this semifinal contest between Villanova and St. Mary's. Both these teams, as mentioned earlier, 4-0 in this tournament. And looking to make it 5-0.
Yeah, Dominic, Coach O'Keefe told me that he was gonna throw everything at the net. He's gotta put every opportunity to shoot a puck up on net. He did just that and was rewarded with a tip puck over goaltender Chilelli for the first goal of this semifinal game.
Just setting the clock up. They got the 15 minutes up on the board. Here we go, period number two. Godden facing off against Keenan. Keenan will take over the puck and right away dumps it into the Villanova zone. DeLuca sets it up there. Jameson can't handle that, and neither could number 22 Dyer for St. Mary's. Godden slap shot, saved there by Chilelli, and he'll hold on and cover it up.
Yeah, as we look at Chilelli there, that's what every goaltender wants. He wants to get into the period early. You think, oh my, you know, Villanova's coming out strong, putting up a shot. No matter, no problem. Chilelli had that with ease.
Second period just underway here. Saved there by DeLuca.
Now DeLuca, Dominic, his opportunity as we look at Captain Rowe from the Knights there. No doubt he's cheering on his squad, giving them a push forward, but the story so far in this game has been the play, as far as I'm concerned, of DeLuca net for Villanova.
Yeah, again, he's been rock solid. If you had to think of a tournament MVP up to this point, Steve, you might want to throw his name into the hat.
Absolutely, Dom. Without a doubt.
Rowe sends it down low, gets it right back, right out front, and intercepted just at the last minute there. Good defensive play by the Wildcats. Stefano sends it back down to the point. This is Rowe working hard. He's handled by Pretty. Jameson gets a stick on it. Pretty now can't clear the zone, or did he? No, they say he kept it in. Ferreira He can't get anywhere with it. Godden off the boards. Stays into the Wildcat zone, though. St. Mary's really pressing and hemming in the Wildcats right now. Pretty off the boards. Farley does clear the zone as it just gets by Cicchini, number four. He goes back for it. Cicchini goes past, intercepted. Jameson. Or Rosa, I should say. That's number 21, Jacob Rosa, sending it into the zone. Interception as Fizikas couldn't get the shot off. Keenan loses the puck behind the net momentarily. Wildcats now trying to create an opportunity here for themselves. Shot from the left, deflected, scores! It's going to be number 10, Jake Menard, getting his stick on that puck. 2-0 Villanova.
Dominic, look at that celebration in the corner from the, the Wildcat team, and why not? What a great tip again. Dom, that's a second goal today where Villanova has been able to get a stick on a puck that's come from the point. Grant O'Keefe's strategy of bringing it back to the point, putting it on net, and getting bodies there is really working for him this afternoon. What an excited and happy Villanova Wildcats team at this point of the game.
Huge goal, 1:59 into the second period. Jake Menard gets a stick on a shot from the point, deflection. The goaltender, Cilelli, was going one way. That puck off the deflection ended up going the other way.
Dominic, I said yesterday afternoon, the way you score goals is when you get a goaltender moving. When a goaltender moves, you can score goals.
See how Villanova responds now if they have that much more momentum. There's another quick chip shot towards the net, and Cilelli able to carry or cover up this time.
Dominic, it was number 9, Jacob DeLuca, from number 14, Quinn.
All right.
Quinn Fizikas, sorry. DeLuca from Fizikas, giving the Wildcats a 2-0 lead here in this game.
There goes my eyes again, Steve. I thought it was, Menard was definitely going through the zone, and I thought it was him that got the stick on it, but we'll go with DeLuca for sure.
Dominic, when goals are scored like that, it's hard to tell who scored the goal. And you know what? That's why the goal is scored. The goaltender doesn't know either. The St. Mary's defenders don't know. And that's the whole point. When there's traffic in front of the net, shots go to the front of the net, anything can happen. That's how you score goals in playoff hockey.
Take a look at that Villanova bench. Trying to remain calm and just stay focused. From the faceoff, that puck offside, goes the Wildcats go offside.
Dom, just again, it was number 9, Jacob DeLuca, from number 14, Quinn Fizikas. 2-0 Wildcats at 12:33 in this period.
Play goes into the Villanova zone. Here's Rosa. A good crisp pass up to number 19, that is Geniak. Rosa following up now. Geniak knocked to the ice by Brunetta. Brunetta, a big, tough customer back there for the St. Mary's team.
The referees are showing restraint, Dom, this afternoon. This morning, sorry.
Let the boys play. Just as long as they're consistent, Steve, I'm okay with that.
Yep.
This is Godden, the captain. Sends it down low behind the net. Dyer takes over for St. Mary's. He takes a hit from Rosa. Puck shot out into the neutral zone. It slides all the way down to the Villanova end. St. Mary's takes advantage of it and gets a wholesale line change going. Long pass, that's deflected by Menard, number 10, but it can't connect. And now they're calling it high stick. So the faceoff will come just outside the St. Mary's blue line in front of the Villanova bench. 11:41 to go in period number 2.
Yeah, there's Jonathan Dwyer, assistant captain for the St. Mary's College. You know, he's wondering, what do we got to do here this afternoon? He's chatting with his coach on the bench right now. Well, what St. Mary's has to do, Dom, is continue to be physical and try to create time and space for themselves.
Banks. His pass off the stick of Trunzo. Bags will get it right back. He circles in the neutral zone, takes a hit, still carries on though. Bags, right side pass over here to Trunzo. Trunzo can't get anywhere now. He gets a handle on it, takes a hit, gets the pass over to Porco. Porco carries over the blue line. He stopped momentarily now for good as number 2, Curtis Cunningham, comes up with that puck. Fans calling for an offside, but not getting anywhere with that. Pass deflected as Trunzo's pass was trying to get through. in the corner. Play as the scrum goes on there. Banks keeps it in at the point. He'll just send it over to the other side. Ferreira trying to get out front. Nice collapse there by the Wildcats, and they take over the puck. Oh, there's another big hit. As I'll tell you what, St. Mary's hasn't given up on the physicality. As
no,
that was Cecchini laying out a hit moments ago. Here is Cecchini. His pass, not a good one, as Schmidt momentarily came up with it. Here's the captain for St. Mary's, Austin Rowe. Rowe trying to get to the outside. Rowe getting to the net. Rowe, backhander, a weak one. DeLuca makes a couple of saves. They're whacking at it, and finally the play is blown down as DeLuca shuts the door.
Dom, what stands out to me right now in front of DeLuca is I got five white shirts in that blue paint. Coach O'Keefe's strategy there is to just smother that net. DeLuca's not a big guy, but when you get five white shirts in that blue paint, give St. Mary's no room.
10-10 remaining here in the second period. 2-0, Villanova with a goal in each period so far. That shot goes wide of the net. Pass out front. Villanova's there to block it up. Here's Rosa turning it up ice. Off the wall, Rosa trying to find God, and he does get a stick on it. He'll send it into the St. Mary's zone. Cecchini being chased. And are we getting our first penalty? We are, Steve.
Looks like it. Looks like referee. I see a red armband going down to his ankle. Dom, you know that means tripping.
It's going to go against Villanova. It's going to be the captain, Ernest Godden, going to the box. So St. Mary's will try to take advantage of this power play situation and get that lead cut in half.
If I'm Coach Oliveira from St. Mary's now, now's my opportunity to slow things down and find that all-important shot.
St. Mary's now with the extra man takes over. Cecchini over to Rowe. Rowe makes a couple of moves. He gets it inside the blue line. Rowe now trying to cut to the net. Rowe out front. Nobody home there for the Knights. Good play there by the Wildcats. That was, I believe, number 22. No, I should check that. Not number 22. He's in the box.
Dom, that's okay. But what's important here that the Wildcats aren't too aggressive on this penalty and burn out their legs. They have an opportunity to rest a bit while they're killing this penalty if they play it right.
It was Cruikshank, number 23. Quick shot blocked again by Purdy that time. Play comes to the point. Brunetta. Rowe. Down low, Rowe gets it back. He can't handle it. Dyer keeps it in at the point. Dyer now looking for some space to Brunetta. Porco to Rowe. Porco back in the corner. He's hit by Purdy, number five. Here's Rowe, lane to the net. Rowe back in, a save by DeLuca as he just got a piece of it. And doing a good job there, number 23, Jacob Cruikshank.
Dominic, I have to give Villanova penalty kill unit here a lot of credit. They're fronting shooters well, and what that means is they are getting in shooting lanes. St. Mary's has nothing to look at.
Cicchetta dishes it into the Villanova zone. Fanning on it there is Cole Welsh. He gets another crack at it, and he banks it off the glass effectively. 20 seconds remaining in the St. Mary's power play. 8:04, 02, 01, 8 minutes to go here in the second period. And Villanova doing a very good job of penalty killing here right
tremendous.
Now.
Tremendous. You know, a tremendous job by Villanova here. They're giving St. Mary's nothing to work with. They're being aggressive at the right times.
Rosa takes out his man. Brunetta takes over the puck off the glass, looking for his linemate, Cecchetta. Ends up into the Villanova zone. Here's number two, Curtis Cunningham. He takes a hit behind the net, the play goes. Cunningham hits his man. This is Trunzo. He leaves it there for Cecchetta. Play at the point, and Villanova is able to clear the zone, giving chase is number seven, Mitch Schmidt. He's beaten to the puck by Bags. Here's Ticelli. St. Mary's just with no time and space, Steve. Every time they touch the puck, there's a Villanova jersey right on them.
Villanova Wildcats, Dom, they really seem to be the ones taking over this game physically. After scoring that goal, they feel real comfortable.
bags a one-timer from the point. DeLuca with a really good look at it. He makes the save easily.
And speaking of looking comfortable, what can we say about that player, 33 DeLuca? He has been solid in that net. Now he's got a two-goal lead. He can get out, be aggressive, keep his shoulders square, and challenge St. Mary's shooters.
Well, he's coming off a shutout game yesterday. And so far today, in this morning contest, he's shut the door again. Bags, his shot blocked at the point by Rosa. Cicchini. Pretty gets a stick on it momentarily there. McGregor can't clear the zone. Here's Sacchetta, shot out front, that goes wide of the net. Rosa takes a big hit, but he does his job in getting the puck out. Number four, Daniel Cicchini. His pass goes into the neutral zone. Pretty, John Pretty can't get anywhere with it. Here's Godden over the blue line. Godden has a man with him. That's number 14, Quinn Fizikas. Fizikas into the corner, takes a hit, loses the puck.
Nice hand-eye coordination.
Oh boy,
there,
he saved a breakaway, I think, Steve.
Sure did. Great job by the Villanova defenseman.
There's a blown pass, and here's Rowe trying to get to the net again. McGregor sends it around to the right side. This is Fizikas. His pass off a leg. Here's Dyer. He'll take over. Dyer at the center stripe. Just shovels it into the Villanova zone. McGregor to Pretty. To Pignanelli. Pignanelli just tips it into the Villanova zone. Fizikas battling his man. Menard comes in to help out. Three Villanova Wildcats. Menard up front, saved by Cicelli. Another shot, another save by Cicelli. Has two great scoring opportunities for Villanova. The Wildcats still plugging away. Fizikas stopped right out in front of the net. Oh my, what goaltending there. And now we got...
Referees are not calling anything behind the play, Dom.
Fans thought that one of the Villanova players were tripped up and interfered with, and they're saying it again there, right there.
You know what? You said it early in the game. We want the teams to settle this game. As far as I'm concerned, the referees are doing a good job staying out of it.
As long as they're consistent, Steve. That's all you want is consistency.
Right.
If you're going to let it go both ways. Here's a look at that last scoring flurry for the Wildcats, Steven. You know what, gotta give credit to Michael Cilelli. He made two or three huge saves there, and Villanova just kept pushing. They created another scoring opportunity just shortly after this, but boy, oh boy, Cilelli made some huge saves, and we'll see if that factors in the game here later on.
Yeah, down 2-0, he can let nothing buy him at this point of the game.
I'll tell you what, if Villanova goes up 3-0, it's gonna be hard for this team, St. Mary's team, to come back. I know they're a very good team, but boy, a 3-0 lead in this tournament this late in the game.
Yeah, Villanova, Dominic, have been very effective at getting it out high off the glass in the neutral zone and then clogging up that neutral zone. They're coming out, standing on their blue line saying, okay, come on at us, come on at us. And St. Mary hasn't been able to adjust to that.
Here are the Wildcats controlling off to the side of the net. That pass goes astray, kept in at the point, though, by McGregor. He sends it over to his line mate. That's number 24. That's Hunter Hutchins. Finally, St. Mary's is able to clear it. Hutchins just dumps it right back in on the diagonal dump. Bags. Brunetta, he can't control it. You know what? Villanova's got these defensemen thinking because every time that pass is coming to them, they're looking to get hit right away. There's no time and space there, Steve.
But that's what happens.
They're in their heads.
That's right. When you have a physical, aggressive forecheck, defensemen start looking over their shoulders. They worry about getting hit before moving the puck.
Hutchins is battling with his man. That's number 15, Michael Trunzo. This is Schmidt. Right side pass to number 8, Chris Francia, who has one of the two goals. Set up behind the net for Cicchini. Over to Rowe. Rowe's had a good game for St. Mary's. Rowe needs the rush now. Rowe pulls up on the half wall, out front. And a save there by DeLuca. Another save as Ferreira had a couple of Jacob Porco, I should say, had a couple of whacks at it.
Yeah, DeLuca coming up big again for his team for sure. St. Mary's College Dom just must be wondering, just as I was, they're going to wondering what they're going to do. Here it is. St. Mary's bringing in. They're going to put up a great opportunity here on DeLuca. There it is. DeLuca shutting it down low, smothering that puck. Tremendous effort from him.
Back to live action here. Play puck rolls down into the St. Mary's zone. This is Scarfone sending it back behind the net to Stefano. Stefano wraps it around the wall. The right side, nobody there. Rowe can't control it. Purdy now chops it into the St. Mary's zone. This is number four, Cecchini. He uses the net, and now he leads the rush. Daniel Cecchini, his pass to Porco doesn't connect. Porco now will get a second chance at it. Purdy does a good job of taking him off the puck. Rosa battling now. Purdy helps out the situation as Rowe has to go back to his own zone. 2:25 remaining here in period number two. Villanova with a big 2-0 lead right now. Goal in each period. Geniak, he's stopped by Rowe momentarily. Following up is Jacob Rosa. He takes a hit. Play behind the net. This is going to be Scarfone with some time and space. Fans on his pass, and Scarfone just got a stick on it to break up that pass, so he bailed himself out, Steve.
Dominic, under 2 minutes going into the intermission with a down two to nothing. You have to be more aggressive and move that puck with authority.
Well, both these teams looking a little tired right now, Steve, understandably.
For sure.
Quick shot off Fizika's stick, stopped there by Cilelli. Play looking out front. There's another shot. Cilelli makes a save. He gets a stick on it and clears it as Jake Menard had a good crack at the St. Mary's net. Porco knocks his man down. That's Cunningham. Loose puck. Shot that goes wide of the net. Here's Menard leading the rush. Menard over the center stripe, over the blue line. Menard on the left side. Menard stick in. Shot, weak one. Cilelli easily saves that one. 1:21 to go in the second period. 2-0 Villanova.
Yeah, the story so far of this hockey game has been two goals, both coming off of tip-in situations, if you will, by the Villanova Wildcats. Cilelli has to stand up strong for his squad the rest of this hockey game. He has to assume that nothing else can get by me and play accordingly.
From the face-off, St. Mary's controls it. This is number six, Adam Bags. He gets it back behind the net. Bags looks to the right side. He circles. It's being checked there by Mitch Schmidt. Bags makes a good play to Brunetta. That pass goes into the skates of number 19, Lucas Miller-Ferreira. Villanova takes advantage of it, keeps the puck in. Over to the right side, this is Bags. He can't clear the zone. Again, Villanova doing a good job of hemming in St. Mary's right now. Cruikshank doing some good work. Ferreira can't clear it. Kept in at the point by number 17, McGregor. Schmidt battling. Takes a hit from Brunetta. Finally, St. Mary's is able to clear the zone. Half a minute to go here in the second period.
Boy, Dom, St. Mary's doesn't appear to be playing like much of a desperate hockey club.
They look like a very tired team right now, Steve. Ferreira can't get anywhere on that rush. Here's Rosa. He avoids a check from Cecchini.
You know, Dom, we have another period to tell, but maybe just 3 days in a hotel room is catching up with St. Mary's.
Rosa, behind the net, takes a hit there from Dyer. Scrum going on behind the net. The buzzer goes. Two periods is in the book, Steve.
Wow.
And the hometown team,
Dominic,
looking pretty good right now.
Chris Francia from DeLuca in the first period, giving them a 1-0 lead. In the second period, Jacob DeLuca from Quinn Fizikas bringing the Wildcats to a 2-0 lead at the end of the second period. I don't know about you, I didn't necessarily expect that at all, but to the delight of Villanova Wildcats fans, they are up with 15 minutes left to play.
Yeah, they're 15 minutes away to advancing, so they've played well. It's going to be a great third period of hockey. We're going to take a timeout here at the LaSalle Vollmer Center. When we come back, we're going to talk to the director of officiating, John Adams, one of the good guys for sure. He'll tell us all about working this type of tournament and give us his insight as to how the officiating is put together. So,
and Dom, if I could say, I think his group of officials, game in and game out, and certainly this morning, have done a tremendous job. They've shown great restraint. They've let the players settle it.
They have indeed done a good job. So when we come back after the break, we'll talk to the director of officiating, John Adams. You're watching the 2016 OFSAA AAA Boys Hockey Championships on we-tv.ca.
It was one of the most beautiful summer's days.
Pushing the guy aside, and then I was on a burst of speed.
It started out as a very bad marriage breakup.
One day he said, "You guys want to get on your bikes?"
I remember the coconut guys, remember the beach.
My memory of going to New York City was just elating.
I decided that I'm going to Scotland.
That's me crossing the goal line.
I remember going out on the lake.
When I reached that rock, I thought of my mother, and I knew that I had done it.
He takes the lid off, and all these creepy crawly worms on, and he would pretend to eat them.
I just remember us circling around out in the park. She just looked up at me, and she said, "I really love the new house, Mommy."
You know, I hope that was a memory for him, too.
Putting the key in the lock and knowing that we were going to be okay.
Would you give up that memory for money?
No.
Absolutely not.
It's too close to the heart.
No.
Oh, no, I don't even have to think about it. No.
A comprehensive financial plan and an Investors Group consultant will help get more out of your money so you can get more out of life.
From the opening tip-off to the final basket, the St. Clair College Sportsplex will host the best Canada has to offer in women's collegiate basketball. March 16th through March 19th, 8 teams will be putting their best on the floor to gain basketball supremacy at the CCAA level. Complete coverage of this action-packed event hosted by St. Clair College Saints Athletics can be watched exclusively on www.we-tv.ca. We TV, bringing Windsor and Essex County to the world. On Monday, March 28th, the best of Windsor and Essex County sports and athletics will be on display at the 11th Annual Westby Awards, the Sports Oscars of Windsor and Essex County. Joining the celebration and bringing her message of triumph and inspiration will be keynote speaker Miss Heather Abbott, a Boston Marathon bombing survivor. Tickets for the Westby Awards are available at Bob Reum Sports, 4275 Tecumseh Road East, and Windsor Essex Television, located at 6270 Hawthorne Road. Discounted group rates are available. For more information, please visit www.thewesbys.ca. The 11th Annual Westby Awards are brought to you by Unifor Local 444, Central Park Athletics, AM 800 CKLW Radio, and WeTV.
Welcome back to the Vollmer Center in beautiful LaSalle, Ontario, the site of the 2016 OFSAA AAA Boys Hockey Championships. We're being very entertained this morning with a semifinal matchup between the Villanova Wildcats and the St. Mary Knights from Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. The Wildcats leading 2-0. As promised at the break, joining us on the broadcast is the director of officiating for this tournament, one of the good guys from our community, that's for sure, Mr. John Adams. And thanks for doing this with us, John. And
no problem.
Good morning to you. And boy, that was a pretty exciting two periods of hockey.
It was fun to watch. At this stage of the tournament, you really start to get the real good teams here. And the game is, as you can see, a lot of good hitting going on. It's borderline, but it's really good hitting, and the kids are really in it. It's been a very entertaining couple periods so far.
Absolutely. You know, we talked about the kids and how, you know, tired they might be at this point. We don't think of the officials. You guys get no love, but certainly deserve a lot of love. For your guys, it's just as tiring. I mean, this is a lot of hockey in a short period of time.
And the thing that, right on, Dom, and the thing that happens in a game, in these games, is not only is it tiring, you're skating an hour and a half, but the emotional end of it and how it drains you as a person, because as much as the players have pride in their work on the ice, our officials are also very, very much excited about being in a tournament of this magnitude, and it takes its toll physically and mentally on them, because they don't want to, they want there to be there for the kids in the right sense of the game. So it's fun.
And as you always say, you want to let the kids decide it. And I think up to this point, they've done a great job. From the day-to-day operation of this tournament, John, your involvement with the officials, are there meetings, are there evaluations, things like that? How do you go about it?
Well, since we knew OFSAA was coming in, we've done a lot of work in reference to supervising our own officials over the course of the last couple of years, believe it or not, to evaluate the... Not so much guys that skate amazingly well, but we want guys who control a hockey game and think the game the right way. There's so much diversification today in the OHA, the OHL, the OMHA Alliance, that when it comes to high school hockey, we have a different mindset down here of what the way we like the game called. And And what we like to do, because it's a continuation of the classroom, because it's high school, the one aspect that we look at with our officials is the language is almost not there anymore, which you see at other levels. And the other thing that we do when we pick our officials, we pick officials that, like I mentioned earlier, that understand the game. We don't want to be the, as you see in this game, both the officials here are letting them play the game pretty well. I mean, they're borderline calls, but a kid plays all year. The teams play all year. We're not going to be the difference. So the process of finding officials that think that way is what my job was doing this tournament.
And we mentioned that on the broadcast this morning, John, that the officials are obviously letting the guys play, and that's what you hope for and want. And the other thing you look for, and I would imagine in all your years of experience, you just want consistency. And for the most part, I think we've had that with the officials.
Yes, the people in Toronto, when I went to the coaches meeting, Dominic, the main theme of my conversation was that. In the Toronto area, they're used to getting OMHA officials, which call everything. And I told them right at the coaches meeting, you're probably gonna be upset with us in the sense that we don't call enough, because we want you to resolve this game on the ice, and we don't want it to be ourselves. And they were very happy to hear that.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, we want the kids to decide all of this. Got to give a lot of kudos to guys like yourself, John Tellerico, to put something like this together, to have it in our area, John. And I know you support so many sports in our area. Baseball is another one of your passions, but just getting this here and accomplishing this. So what does that mean to you, to John, and to our area?
Well, first of all, thank you. Well, I'm getting older now, Dom. I've been doing this a long time. It's in my heart. You know that. You've followed my career as someone who's been involved with sports for a long time. I believe in helping the community. I believe that it's not always taking things, it's giving back. I actually very much enjoy that part of it. It's something my parents taught me about, you know, that part of life that you can take forever, but it's nice to give back. I'm really enjoying this, especially at 67 years old. Getting older, you never get tired of being around it, being the hoopla, being and seeing people like yourself who I've known for a long time, who've also done an amazing job. It's really gratifying.
Well, we're lucky to have you in the community, that's for sure, because you've been a pillar of strength, and certainly everything you've done. I want to give a really good shout out to John Tellerico.
Good man.
Young guy, and he's the guy that's leading the way for future stuff. So with the combination of the two of you and the other people, hats off to you guys. Thanks for doing this, and thanks for allowing WeTV to be a small part of it. We're certainly thrilled to be here, and again, congratulations on everything up
to
this point, John.
On behalf of the Windsor District Referee Association, the people that I'm involved with this tournament, we're very, very happy to have you here, and thank you very much. And it's been fun so far. Let's keep our fingers crossed. How's that?
Yeah, we got two more games in the period still, so it's going to be a lot of fun, John.
All right,
great
Donnie.
To see you, as always.
Thank you
have
very
a great
much.
Day.
Appreciate
John
it.
Adams, certainly one of the good guys, and doing a great job helping this tournament to create the success that certainly is wanted and needed and being done. We're going to take a quick timeout. When we come back, it's the call of the third period. You're watching the 2016 OFSAA AAA Senior Boys Hockey Championships on we-tv.ca.
It's new. It's fresh. It's innovative. It's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
Manpower, that's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the $1 billion parkway. That's real manpower in action. End to end, over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. Liuna, feel the power.
Welcome back to the LaSalle Vollmer Center in LaSalle, Ontario, the site of the 2016 OFSAA AAA Hockey Championships. Dominic Pop along with Steve Pronger our outstanding crew here with WE TV doing some early morning work for you to bring you all the action live. And we've had a dandy between St. Mary's and Villanova. Period number three underway. Steve Pronger, again, our coach, taking care of breaking down the game for you as we go along here. And I think an early goal is in the wish list for St. Mary's, Steve.
Yeah, Dom, if they want to get back in this hockey game, they have to get shots on net very quickly. You see they're already controlling the play deep in the Villanova end, but they need to get shots on net and people to the front of the net.
That puck steered into the corner. Here's Rowe behind the net. Rowe continues on. Right away, St. Mary's does bring it into the Villanova zone. Quick pass out front. That's off to the side of the net. DeLuca gets a stick on it, and then he makes a great save. As he takes care of business, he robs number eight, Matthew Keenan, who had a good crack at the net. Villanova quickly right back down at the ice. Play into the corner. This is Rosa, Jacob Rosa, trying to work something out in the corner. A lot of tight checking. Here's Rowe, the captain, coming up with it to Cicchini. Cicchini up to Ferreira, or Porco, I should say. Quick shot off of Keenan's stick. DeLuca again makes the save. DeLuca's got to love this television stuff, Steve.
Yeah, for sure. We've said his name too many times, but rightfully so, Dominic. He's standing square. His shoulders are back between the posts, and he's giving St. Mary's no room.
Here's Stefano. Over to his line mate, Marcus Cicchetta. He sends it into the Villanova zone. Cunningham doing a little bit of a stick magic there. Can't get the puck cleared, though. You can see a little more desperation in the St. Mary's game right now, Steve.
Absolutely. They got to have what I call, Dominic, a kitchen sink offense. They got to throw everything at Villanova net. The seats on the bus, their sticks, the pucks, everything.
That shot wide coming off the stick of Pignanelli. St. Mary's will have some space to clear it out. Long shot. DeLuca easily handles that, and he's going to cover up. 1:59 gone by here in period number three. Villanova continues to lead 2-0 over St. Mary's.
As we look at the Villanova standout, DeLuca there for sure. Coach Oliveira of St. Mary's, he's really looking for someone to make a difference here, Dominic. He needs one member of his squad to step up, take control, and find the inside of that net.
Quick shot just goes wide as number 18, Austin Rowe, the captain, was able to get a shot off. Now we're getting the chant in the crowd. Again, the Villanova fans here in force.
Dominic, it looks like school is out early right in front of us.
Yes, it does.
And why not? They're excited to be here. Look at these excited hockey fans. They're cheering their team on. What a story, the Villanova Wildcats.
So far, so good for the host team, that's for sure. Here's Rowe. Over the blue line, Rowe pulls up, takes a hit. And again, Villanova marking up very nicely. Puck comes out, Rowe just slaps it right back in behind the Villanova net. Hutchins with some space, leads the rush. Hutchins to the right side, stick handling, trying to get to the blue line. He can't get there, finally he does. He moves it up to number eight. That's Chris Francia, who has the opening goal of this game way back in the first period. That pass goes into the St. Mary's bench. Don't forget, right after the game, we will have our investors group player of the game. I'll let Coach Steve Pronger make that choice for us. I'm sure he's got a couple of guys in mind right now.
Well, I'm looking at the St. Mary's squad, Dom, and I can honestly, who could it be? I'm not sure, but there's two or three standouts so far from Villanova.
Yep. From the faceoff, Cunningham fans on that shot. It goes wide of the net. DeLuca, his pass doesn't connect. Puck rolls all the way down into the St. Mary's zone. A good job of forechecking there by Fizikas, who created somewhat of a scoring opportunity. St. Mary's trying to come right back now. This is Keenan over the blue line. Keenan's had a strong game. Out front, nobody there for him to connect with. Fizikas can't clear the zone. Cicchini takes over, sends it down behind the net. Stefano. Lucas Stefano back to the point, to Dyer, to Cicchini. Cicchini with the shot, that's deflected wide. Out front, oh, and it almost connected, but Villanova fortunately comes up with the loose puck. Yeah. Off the glass, and the Wildcats in the midst of a wholesale line change.
Villanova's got to watch that backdoor guy in front of their net. They can't be puck watchers in there. Everyone's got to identify a man.
Puck sent into the St. Mary's zone. Jonathan Dwyer, left side. This is number 9, Jacob Porco. Porco over the center stripe, left side pass over to Ferreira. Porco, shot, DeLuca, save again.
Dominic, look how far out he is on top of that blue ice. DeLuca is confident, he is challenging shooters. He is sending a message to St. Mary, nothing is gonna get by me, I am better than you, give me that puck.
Take a look at it, Steve.
Yeah, here it is. Great opportunity for St. Mary's, but look at DeLuca, way out over on the blue ice, standing square. Great job from the Villanova goaltender.
From the faceoff, that shot blocked. Porco will take another crack at it to Ferreira. Out front, comes to the point. This is Bangs. Bangs winds up, shot, save DeLuca, and again, a good job of controlling that rebound.
Dominic, that kid is playing like a wall. The St. Thomas of Villanova fans and coaching staff, teammates must be thrilled with this young man. He's taking this team on his shoulders. St. Mary's is starting to come on a little bit for sure. They have to. They have to put pressure on DeLuca.
Well, there's definitely that urgency and desperation in their game.
Yeah, 10 minutes left. They got to do something.
Right now, they have to try to find a way to solve the goaltender, Lucas DeLuca. Godden sends it around the boards to Quinn Fizikas. He can't get out. Pass out front, that shot blocked. Purdy whacks at it. This is Rowe making some moves. Rowe now can't get it to the point. Godden clears the zone. Godden collides with his own man, Fizikas. Bags passed. Stopped there by number 10, that was Menard. Brunetta up to Trunzo. Trunzo leaves it there for Keenan. He takes a hit. Cunningham switches sides and he'll send it into the St. Mary's zone. Off the glass, Scarfone sends it right back into the Wildcats end. A little bit of a ping pong match going on here right now.
Yeah, we called it badminton yesterday, Dom.
Okay, well, I like ping pong better, but badminton, ping pong, it's going back and forth. That's all I can tell you.
Right.
And that puck ends up in the Villanova bench. 9:28 to go, period number 3. Villanova continues to lead 2-0.
Yeah, we look at Captain Alston Rowe there heading back to his bench. No doubt he's wondering what can he do.
I think he's had a great game though, Steve.
Sure has.
He's worked really hard.
Coach Oliveira there, they're wondering what can we do to solve DeLuca and this Villanova squad. Whatever it is, Dom, they have to play below the dots in the Villanova end.
Shot, that goes to the side of the net. A quick shot off the face. A couple people thought it went in. To the point. Scarfone can't get anywhere with it. And again, Villanova just content with putting it into the neutral zone softly. Kill some of that clock. I'm not saying Villanova's gone into a total shell here, Steve, but they're obviously not pressing like they were earlier in the game. They're content with a 2-0 lead, I think, here.
Yeah, one man going deep to try to pester the defenseman, Dog. They're clogging up the middle of the ice with 4 players.
That shot just wide of the Villanova net as the Knights are doing everything they can to try to get to DeLuca. Here's a chance. It's Rosa on the left side. Rosa takes a little bit of the old school hip check there from Giacchini. I love it.
You don't see those too often.
Nope. Where is Bobby Bond? Here comes Keenan. Keenan, 1-on-2, a quick shot. Glove save by DeLuca.
He makes it look easy at times, and why not? He's playing with confidence. Here comes that old school hip check. You said, where's Bobby Bond, Don? There it is.
There
wow.
He is, right there.
You know, wow. You don't see that as much anymore. It's kind of a lost art, a lost skill. Kind of like plastering has gone the way of drywall.
Yeah. It's all good, though. It's all good. Right away, St. Mary's sends her right back into the Villanova end. You can see right now we're almost 7 minutes into this period, Steve, and the ice at the Villanova end is pretty scuffed up already, whereas it's still pretty fresh down here in the St. Mary's zone.
But that's what we've seen in 2 periods. That's what Villanova seems to just kind of lull their opponents to sleep, and then bammo, a shot goes up on net. They've done it twice.
Again, very opportunistic throughout this tournament have been the Villanova Wildcats.
You know, there's one thing as you look at the St. Mary's bench. You got to work hard for sure, but there's a difference between playing smart and playing hard. Villanova seems to be playing smart.
From the faceoff, the Knights control. This is Brunetta leading the rush. sends it up to Ferreira. He just softly deflects it and it rolls into DeLuca. Yes. Again, we'll be back at 1 o'clock. That will be the bronze medal game. Steve Pronger along with Bill Kelso will give you the call on that one. And then the gold medal game at 3 o'clock. So two outstanding games still to come here on we-tv.ca.
We will see one of these teams at 3 and one
yep.
at 1.
Yep. Rosa takes over the puck. He loses it now on the half wall. Scrum going on. Here's Rosa battling back. He gets it. Over to his line mate. That's Geniak. Lucas Geniak. Trying to get by Brunetta. Brunetta stands him up. Takes over the loose puck. Hutchins pitches in from his point position. Hutchins right out front, and he just couldn't get his stick on it. Kept in at the point by number 17. That's McGregor. Goes behind the St. Mary's net. And you can see four guys back for Villanova and just the one guy high. You're yeah. right, Steve.
Yeah, they're going to clog that neutral zone and challenge them to make a play at their blue line.
Ferreira shot. DeLuca steers it into the corner. Godden fans on that pass, but now he gets the puck right back. Godden, right side pass over here to number 19. Geniak, he just chips it in, and Villanova again in the midst of a wholesale line change. This is Cecchini, who's had a strong game. Cecchini leads the rush, takes a hit as he's taken down by number 9, Jacob DeLuca. Dyer. Cecchini, shot. DeLuca, save. Puck loose at the side, and somehow that puck stays out of the net.
Again, Dominic, you see five white shirts plus the goaltender in front of the Villanova net. Coach Grant O'Keefe has said, look, we have to swarm around our net. They're giving no room at all for St. Mary's. I don't know where St. Mary's is going to find an inch to put that puck past DeLuca, Dom. I really don't.
It's going to have to be a pretty special shot, that's for sure. 6:23 to go here in the third period.
Dominic, you look at the St. Mary's squad, they're getting desperate. The problem with they face and they have to overcome, they can't get too excited.
Wildcats from the faceoff control, they send it out into the neutral zone. The chant begins again from the hometown crowd here. The Wildcats have tremendous support here this morning. Right up front, scores! Number 10, Lucas Stefano gets the Knights on the board. A huge goal with 6:04 remaining.
Okay, you wondered, Dom, what was going to happen. There it is. You look at Stefano celebrating. He trips himself up in front of the bench. He's excited, of course. Really, when you look at DeLuca there, perhaps a little miscue here at the side of the net. DeLuca just stopping the puck, leaving it for nobody. His defenders thought they were going to wrap it around. Wow, St. Mary's a recipient of a gift there, Dom.
Lucas Stefano gets them on the board, 6:04 remaining. Stefano might recognize that name, Steve.
I certainly do, his brother playing in the OHL.
With the Barrie Colts, I believe now. He had some time with the Spitfires and was dealt over to the Colts.
Oh. Dominic, we have a new hockey game with 6 minutes left.
Absolutely. The nail biting has begun, Steve.
That's right.
Right away, St. Mary's comes back looking for the equalizer. Brunetta keeps it in at the point. Behind the Villanova net, Purdy pins his man up against the boards.
Dominic, you saw yesterday Villanova played with a one goal lead and won that game. They know how to do it. They've been here before.
It's a tough task. I don't know, this St. Mary's team is pretty strong, Steve. I don't know if I'd just sit back at this point, but we'll see what happens here. This is Porco. He can't get through the defense. Cole Welsh, I should say, stood him up. And again, puck set down the length of the ice. Villanova with really quick line changes right now, Steve.
Yeah, they got to keep fresh legs on the ice at all times.
Here's Rowe, quick shot, save DeLuca as Rowe takes a hit just after firing that shot. And DeLuca again covering up nicely.
Defense is the name of the game for Villanova right now. And the best place to play defense, Dom, you can't do the prevent defense like you're in hockey. Sorry, like you're in football. The goal scorer, Lucas Stefano, number 10 for Villanova, with assists from Michael Trunzo and Austin Rowe, gives them a 2-1.
Gets them on the scoreboard.
Puts them on the scoreboard. Sorry, Tom.
Rosa now. Sends it over to Godden. Godden trying to get to the net. Godden looks out front. That pass doesn't connect. It comes out, kept in by Cunningham. Or check that. That's number 9, DeLuca. Ferreira, a soft dish into the Villanova zone. Godden takes over. Left side pass along the wall. Here's the goal scorer, Stefano for St. Mary's, battling with Cunningham. Stefano comes up with the loose puck. Looks out front. Here's Rowe trying to get to the front. His pass to Bags. Bags shot blocked. Dyer smartly puts it into the corner. Here's Rowe again. Rowe really working hard. Out front, nobody home there for St. Mary's. Villanova have a chance to clear it out. This is Jacob Rosa. Rosa down the right side on his off wing. Rosa pulls up behind the net. Rosa pinned there by number 6. That's Adam Bags. Geniak coming in to help out for Villanova. Geniak battling on the boards. This is Dyer now for St. Mary's, taking over the loose puck. Dyer shovels it ahead to number 9, and that's Porco. Porco behind the net, looks out front. Shot saved to Luca as the puck came loose momentarily. Trunzo got a stick on it. There's a long wrister from the point. DeLuca with a good look at it. He'll cover up. 3:35 to go in period number 3. 2-1 Villanova.
Yeah, again, getting St. Mary's on the board with Lucas Stefano from Trunzo and Austin Rowe. That was a fortuitous goal for them, Dominic. Does DeLuca have what it takes to win this game for Villanova? We're going to see.
From the faceoff, the puck goes behind the Villanova net. Kept in at the point there nicely by number 20, Carmen Scarfone. Linesman in the play there as he was trying to get out of there from the faceoff circle. Brunetta pedals back, sends a pass. That doesn't connect. He was looking for his teammate Trunzo. Here come the Wildcats. That's number 10, Menard, just shoveling it into the St. Mary's zone. He immediately goes and makes a line change. Keenan over the blue line. A dump pass here to number 15, Trunzo. Trunzo looking for some room. Checked there momentarily by Cunningham. Puck goes into the corner. Keenan takes a hit from Cunningham. Behind the Villanova net now. St. Mary's trying to get that puck out front. Villanova doing a good job covering up. Kept in at the point there by Cicchini. Over to Bags. His wrist shot blocked. Again, how many shots have we seen blocked here?
Dominic, Villanova has to get in shooting lanes in their own end, and they're doing it very, very effectively. Everybody's playing goaltender out there at this moment.
2:20 to go here in the third period. DeLuca sets it up behind the net for number 9, DeLuca. That's DeLuca to DeLuca.
Three DeLucas on Villanova.
Oh my. Here's Rowe, the captain. He can't get by his man, Bryce McGregor, who poke checks him. Puck kept in, though. 2 minutes to go in this one. Out front, and that shot just goes wide. Bags. Another shot blocked. Oh, there's a trip. We're going to let it go, I think. Fans calling for a penalty here. 1:10 to go here. Let's see if St. Mary's can get the puck down to get the goaltender out. Dyer sends it up the boards, but again, Villanova very effective right now. Cruikshank doing a good job of forechecking. Here's Porco. Goaltender's out of the net for St. Mary's. Puck into the Villanova zone. Under a minute to go here. The winner going to the gold medal game. 2-1. We get a face-off as that puck over the glass. 2-1 Villanova leads it with 50.9 seconds remaining.
Dominic, I don't know what the fans in this building are feeling, or certainly our viewers on WeTV.ca, but I'm telling you, what a great hockey game to call. And I see one of the two squads, they didn't notice this, Dom, maybe you did, is calling their timeout right now. Good move.
Yeah, not surprised. Again, at that point, we will remind you that we will have our Investors Group Player of the Game. We'll have that immediately after the contest. And don't forget, we'll be back here at 1 o'clock this afternoon with the bronze medal game. And then at 3 o'clock, the gold medal game.
Dominic, there's definitely a couple candidates on the Villanova Wildcat squad for Investors Group Player of the Game. It's going to be tough to choose one of them for sure. But when we look at St. Mary's, 50 seconds, someone in St. Mary's has got to make a difference. The coach right now, Oliveira, he's trying to make a difference. He's trying to make up a play that's going to work. But look at these fans, Dominic. Look at these Villanova Wildcat supporters.
Yeah, a good crowd here, a good contingent. I'll tell you what, if they get in that gold medal game, I wouldn't be surprised if this place gets packed at 3 o'clock.
There may not be any room to call the game up here.
Well, you've got reserved seats, Steve, so you're okay. You'll get a seat, buddy. Face-off. Important face-off. As Villanova's able to clear out Park. Rosa's got an empty net. Rosa shoots off to the side of the net. Rosa gets it back. Rosa trying to circle. And he tries to wrap around. He couldn't finish it off. 35 seconds remaining. Here comes St. Mary's. Keenan, shot. That goes high and wide. Kept in at the point momentarily. No, Rowe can't keep it in. St. Mary's has to clear the zone. Here's Cicchini. Over to number 20, Scarfone. Scarfone has to circle. 20 seconds remaining. Up to Porco. Porco over the blue line. Porco drop pass to Rowe. Rowe trying to send it down deep. Rowe up front. Nobody there for St. Mary's. Kept in over here at the other side. There's a shot blocked again by the St. Mary's player. That was number 19, Gignac. And that one slowly rolls into DeLuca. 4.9 seconds remaining. Face-off to the stick side of Villanova goaltender Lucas DeLuca.
Okay, the last thing that coach, here it goes. I was going to say the last thing that the Villanova coach, Dom, wants is a timeout right now. He wants to get on with this. However, St. Mary's is going to use their timeout to try to get this all-important one face-off play. Dominic, can the St. Mary's center iceman win this draw, get it to a guy who's going to put that shot up to beat DeLuca?
Some of the fans here, Steve, I'll tell you what, they're shaking. You can see it, and they are right into this. There's some of the young fans, maybe some of the student body from Villanova High School, but great to see these guys out supporting their friends and schoolmates. That's an awesome support. And there's actually some fans here from Sault Ste. Marie off to our right here, Steve, that have been very enthusiastic. So hats off to those fans making the trek down here and coming support their school as well.
Don, there's the coaching staff from Villanova. Surprisingly, look how cool, calm, collected they look. You know, but I'm sure deep down inside, their hearts are pumping at rapid speed.
Oh, yeah.
How about DeLuca's heart and Nettis?
Here we go. 4.9 seconds. Face off to the stick side. Goes behind the net to the side. That's going to do it. This game is over. Villanova wins, defeating St. Mary's 2-1 in a thriller. And now we got some extracurricular activity. This is maybe some frustration here, Steve.
Yeah, for sure. St. Mary's, Dom, is no doubt frustrated. Some of their players taking exception. You know, they're sent out to be aggressive on that face-off. No doubt that energy and adrenaline is carrying over. Wow, Dominic, what a game here. What a finish for the Villanova Wildcats. No doubt you're going to come back to us with the Investors Group Player of the Game. And, Dom, who's it going to be?
Well, I think we got Jacob DeLuca along with Lucas DeLuca.
Two players of the game, and why not?
Yep.
Look at that celebration, Dominic.
All right, with that, we're going to take a timeout. Villanova advances to the gold medal game. They defeat St. Mary's 2-1. When we come back, the Investors Group Player of the Game. You're watching the 2016 OFSAA AAA Hockey Championships on we-tv.ca.
It was one of the most beautiful summer's day.
Pushing the guy aside, and then I was on a burst of speed.
It started out as a very bad marriage breakup. One day he said, "You guys want to get on your bikes?"
I remember the coconut guys, Limber the Beach.
My memory of going to New York City was just elating.
I decided that I'm going to Scotland.
That's me crossing the goal line.
I remember going out on the lake.
When I reached that rock, I thought of my mother. And I knew that I had done it.
He takes the lid off and all these creepy crawly worms. Come on, and he would pretend to eat them.
I just remember us circling around out in the park. She just looked up at me and she said, I really love the new house, Mommy.
You know, I hope that was a memory for him too.
Putting the key in the lock and knowing that we were gonna be okay.
Would you give up that memory for money?
No.
Absolutely not.
It's too close to the heart.
No.
Oh no, I don't even have to think about it. No.
A comprehensive financial plan and an Investors Group consultant will help get more out of your money so you can get more out of life.
From the opening tip-off to the final basket, the St. Clair College Sportsplex will host the best Canada has to offer in women's collegiate basketball. March 16th through March 19th, 8 teams will be putting their best on the floor to gain basketball supremacy at the CCAA level. Complete coverage of this action-packed event hosted by St. Clair College Saints Athletics can be watched exclusively on www.we-tv.ca. We TV, bringing Windsor and Essex County to the world. On Monday, March 28th, the best of Windsor and Essex County sports and athletics will be on display at the 11th Annual Westby Awards, the Sports Oscars of Windsor and Essex County. Joining the celebration and bringing her message of triumph and inspiration will be keynote speaker Miss Heather Abbott, a Boston Marathon bombing survivor. Tickets for the Westby Awards are available at Bob Reum Sports, 4275 Tecumseh Road East, and Windsor Essex Television, located at 6270 Hawthorne Road. Discounted group rates are available. For more information, please visit www.thewesbys.ca. The 11th Annual Westby Awards are brought to you by Unifor Local 444, Central Park Athletics, AM 800 CKLW Radio, and WE TV. It's new, it's fresh, it's innovative, it's WE TV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WE TV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WE TV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WE TV, we got you covered.
Welcome back to the Vollmer Center, the site of the 2016 OFSAA AAA Hockey Championships. The story continues. The Villanova Wildcats continue to be that story. I can't call them the Cinderella story anymore because this team is the real deal. They find ways to win. They just beat a very good St. Mary's Knights team from Sault Ste. Marie, a 2-1 outcome. Our Investors Group players of the game, we're going two again for this one. No stranger to us, his third straight call with us, Lucas DeLuca. Joining him is Jacob DeLuca. I got those names right, correct, guys? Okay. Okay, nail-biting time, obviously. You know what? You've got no pulse in you here, okay, Lucas? How do you remain calm and just stay focused through all that?
I just think it's any other game, honestly. Just forget about the pressure. It's just like, we're this far, might as well keep going, you know? So.
What about for you, Jacob? What are you guys thinking out there? Obviously, your job is to protect your goalie and make things happen in front of him. How did you guys accomplish that today?
Well, it was a total team effort. Everyone stayed back, played defensively, and went up when we needed to. And obviously, with Aluka back in net, it always helps that we have a strong goaltender helping us out.
One thing you guys did very effectively throughout this game, and you just alluded to it, Jacob, was blocking a lot of shots. You guys got into the lanes and really took a lot of time and space and shots. Was that stressed in the pregame talk?
Yeah, well, we knew the defense were a really strong core, and they had a lot of good shots, so we made sure to talk about that and make sure we get in the lane and make sure we helped Aluka back there. So, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And for yourself, you had a lot of good looks at the pucks, but you also made some key saves, timely saves. This team, Lucas, has become what we say opportunistic. You do your thing, and these guys score the key goals at the time, the right times. How do you accomplish that? How do you make those things type of things happen?
I don't know. Just our coaches give us a lot of hype. Every game we're going in, it's just getting more hype. So yeah.
Okay, well, you have to wonder now, this is going to be your sixth game, you're 5-0. The obvious question, guys, how much is left in the tank? Or is it just one of those things you're running on adrenaline now?
I think playing four lines like we do, it helps everyone get rested and gives them a lot of time to rebuild their energy. And it gives everyone a lot of energy going through all games and periods.
All right. Well, hey, guys, congratulations.
Thank you.
You had a great, nice crowd out there today, didn't you? It's going to get better. Trust me, at 3 o'clock, these guys will be back in action. They'll be playing for a gold medal. Don't forget, we'll be back here at 1 o'clock for the bronze medal game. So two more good hockey games here at the OFSAA Championships, and we'll have them for you on WE TV. The story here this morning, Villanova defeats St. Mary's by a 2-1 score. They are in the gold medal game. That's it. That's it from the Vollmer Center for now. We'll be back at 1 o'clock. Until then, this is Dominic Papa wishing you a great day. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. We'll see you later on this afternoon.